with all their heart and with all their understanding and with all their strength, and to love one's neighbor as himself is much more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices.
It says to love him with all your heart, all your understanding, and all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself.
Well, that's one
that
of
is
the
more
two
important
commandments
than all burnt offerings and sacrifices. What does that mean to you? What does that mean to you when you think about that?
Point is
to love him over everything in this world, anything that has ever been given to you, that has ever made you happy.
Put him first in your life. Love him with all your heart, your soul, your mind. Put God first in your life, not second. And love your neighbor. It's one of his commandments.
And that's pleasing in his sight.
Absolutely.
That's very pleasing in his sight, to be able to acknowledge him in everything, in the good and the bad, in the happy, in the down times, when we fail.
Amen. Read that for me, brother.
Matthew 6:33. So seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, praise and all these things shall be added unto you.
Things of your heart, things that you desire, things that you don't even know that you desire, he gives to you, and be such a blessing within itself. Praise God. Jesus told us to repent, for the kingdom of God is near. Matthew 5:17. Brother Josh.
Matthew 5:17.
Yes, sir.
Thank not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
The kingdom of God is near.
Hate me to interrupt you, but
there's a consequence if we do not obey and repent. Jesus says, unless you repent, you too will all perish. That's found in Luke 13:3. Praise God.
I'm room number 00. I'm just kidding. I'm the chaplain.
Well, room 33.
33?
Then I come to destroy the law of the prophets. And I'm not
Squires. Room 11.
Is that right? Snow 27.
That one on. It said, Jesus told us to repent, for the kingdom of God is near. Alright. There is a consequence if we do not obey and repent. Kingdom of God is near. Repent. We don't know when he's going to come. He's going to come like thief in the night.
What is repentance?
Turning from our ways. Turning from what we know is wrong.
Repent mean?
I don't know. Why don't you tell us, Mr. Spagnuolo?
Change of mind.
Thank you.
Not only change your mind, you got to change your purpose in your life.
No.
I did a Bible study on repentance. It's a big word, and it's actually used, I forget how many times in the Bible, but it's used a lot in the Bible about repentance.
Amen.
There's a consequence if we do not obey and repent. Jesus says, unless you repent, you too will all perish. That's found in Luke 13:3.
13:3, you want to get that?
Yeah.
Go ahead, man. Please do.
I tell you nay, but except ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish.
Repent also means to ask God to forgive you your sins and accept Him as your Lord and Savior that died on the cross for you. Repentance is a very big word. It has a lot of meaning. It's just not, just that means to change your mind, change your purpose in your life, change your attitude.
But the biggest thing is you really have to want to repent
yeah.
and mean it.
To
Small words unless you truly mean it from your heart.
It's also that ask for forgiveness when you repent.
Amen. So, the kingdom of God is near. Repent, or ye too will perish. If we don't obey God, we have to pay the consequences. Genesis 2:16 tells of the first time man did not obey and the consequences he had to pay.
Brother Bevins. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat.
Can you read the next one for me?
Next verse. But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die. And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper comparable to him.
That's good. Thank you. So, he told him that he should not eat of the fruit. And what happened? He got stripped down. He had to work. And by the sweat of his brow, he had to eat. So that's, I believe, comes a little bit after. Let me find it. It says right here, amen, praise God. This is an account of the heavens and earth when they were created. When the Lord made the earth and the heavens, I'm sure the field not appear. Is it 315?
317.
There it is, 17. There it is. Amen. Read it for me. Praise God.
Well, starting at 315, I say, and I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed, and it shall bruise thy heel. Bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. And to the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception and sorrow. Thou shalt bring forth children, and thy desire shall be to thy husband, and he shall rule over thee. And to Adam he said, because thou hast hearkened to the voice of thy wife, and hast eaten of the tree, of which I command thee, saying, thou shalt not eat of it, curse is the ground for thy sake, and sorrow shall thou eat of it all the days of thy life. Thorns also and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herbs of the field.
Praise God, thank you.